Thanks, Gene. It happened here late last night. 7 mutilated bodies found strewn about the 300-acre Texas campground behind me. An idyllic summer setting turned to tragedy a mere 24 hours after children went home for the season. Authorities are baffled by the lack of leads, having recovered only a machete with no discernible fingerprints. Reporting live from San Antonio, I'm Roy Merkin. Back to you, Gene.
Welcome back, Spencer. Take a seat. How's the tour been so far?
Texas was pretty cool. We went to San Antonio. I tried to piss on the Alamo, but we ran out of time. Trying to do like an Aussie thing, you know?
I sense there's a butt coming.
Well, the dreams are still there.
Even with the diazepam?
Yeah. It lasted for about a week, I want to say, but then as soon as the tour started...
The same imagery as before, with the girl?
No. Well, the girl is there, but there's another girl who looks a lot like your colleague, Dr. Stonebridge. And now I'm in the dream, and my band is too.
That's an interesting change. What are you doing?
It's really weird, but we're all camp counselors. And we're shutting down this camp because it's the end of the season. And we start to hear these voices. Voices from dead counselors of the past. Ghosts, really. And they're telling us, or warning us, rather, that death is coming.
Drowning our mistakes, fueled by the flood we pay in blood, the curse of Crystal Lake.
Friday. Careful, mommy.
real improvement, isn't it? I mean, all of the protagonists survive this time.
Well, I didn't finish the story yet.
Go on. Well, that's not exactly the soothing kind of story that helps with uninterrupted sleep now, is it?
No, it isn't. Can we maybe get Dr. Stonebridge to up my dosage of diazepam? Just to get through the tour, maybe? I haven't had a full night's sleep in a week now.
Well, Spencer, as much as that may seem like the solution, it's better to get to the bottom of what's causing the anxiety, rather than to use these drugs. They can be highly addictive, you know. Did the dream start when you sought out Dr. Michelson 2 years ago? What was going on then?
It goes a lot further back than that.
Really? How far?
Since I was a little kid.
Interesting. And does your childhood stand out as being the source of the anxiety?
No, I mean, I had a pretty normal upbringing, nothing special, nothing crazy. Nothing really sticks out. Are we doing okay on time? Looks like we're almost at the 1 hour mark.
Well, sure, but I have plenty of time.
I don't want to do that. It's not fair to go over. I'm recording in LA next week, so let's say the week after that, and then we could sort of get to the bottom of this, take it from there.
Fair enough. Well, why don't you just see Karen on the way out, and we'll set up a time for us to get to the bottom of this, okay?
Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you, Spencer.
See you in 2 weeks.
Knock, knock.
You know you're supposed to knock on the outside of the door.
Hypothetically speaking, what are my responsibilities to law enforcement? You know, if I believed one of my patients may actually have killed someone.
Well, we can go to law enforcement if the patient has specifically said that they had or planned to commit a murder. But short of an outright admission, what is discussed is between patient and doctor confidentiality either way. That's a really specific question, Ian. I mean, should we go to counsel or?
No, I mean, not at all. It was purely a hypothetical question. Only intellectual, in fact, you know. It's, what is that?
Kale salad? Ugh.